Now, going back to our top story, we're joined by Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega for an update on the situation of Filipinos who have evacuated from Gaza. USEC, good afternoon. Thank you very much for your time.
How do you do? Thank you.
We are very grateful for the government's efforts in safely having 40 of our kababayans out of Gaza. We're also, of course, hoping for their safe return. How are they and what's their situation now, sir?
Well, I'm checking now because the figures... it changes. They are still on their way to Cairo. They should have been there hours ago, but there was a problem. On the way, there was a 2 or 3 hour delay because the bus could not move because of fog.
Okay.
Desert fog. So they should have been in Cairo by now, which is still morning Cairo time. We are plus six. But surely by the afternoon of Cairo, they will be in Cairo. And from there, they will be given accommodation until they are flown probably as early as Thursday. And they will probably arrive as early as Friday. Here you see the picture of the ambassador and his team with the Filipinos at the Rafah crossing. So it took several hours for them to cross last night, meaning for the papers to be obtained. But they got it.
USEC, even though their bus has been delayed, they are in a very safe area?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, that's good to know. Sir, will you be able to tell us what was key maybe in the negotiations and in the discussions and arrangements for our kababayans to be able to leave Gaza?
Because when you discuss diplomacy, you don't reveal everything.
Of course, sir.
We'll just say that what we do say is there. It's known that we are friends of Israel and of Egypt. Israel certainly appreciates the support that our president expressed for Israel, for the vote of abstention that we presented during the UN resolution vote at the General Assembly recently. They appreciate the years of friendship between the State of Israel and the Republic of the Philippines. And, of course, the fact that, they honor our kababayans there in Israel, including those who died along with the Hamas. So it wasn't really so difficult for us to talk to them and tell them that the Filipinos should be given some priority. The same with Egypt, because they're also appreciative through the years of our good relations with them. And they are fully confident that the Filipinos who will enter Egypt, and they have entered now, will not cause trouble in Egypt and will be ready to go home. Because what they were avoiding was the entry of people who just want to be refugees in Egypt. And of course, we assured them that that would not be the case. So that was quite important. But of course, a lot of people who question the Philippine government for the decisions we have taken recently. It turns out, clearly, they were the right decisions.
Okay. Just a clarification, sir. There were, I believe, 46 were allowed to leave, but there were only 40 who actually left. What happened to the other six?
Well, there's a father and son who had to remain because the little kid was still in the hospital. The father and son, though, are going to the border now. In fact, they are at the border now.
Okay.
And so it will be a delayed crossing. The four were having last-second thoughts yesterday as to whether they would like to cross and actually be repatriated to the Philippines, because what they wanted to do was to remain possibly in Egypt. So they remain in Gaza instead of crossing. But today, they will cross.
How about those who had second thoughts of leaving their spouses or didn't want to leave because of their spouses? I understand there has been a verbal go-ahead given for Palestinian spouses to go with them, and you're just waiting for the formal writing?
Yes. That was something indicated to our ambassador in Israel on the ground, and also to our ambassador in Egypt. The problem, though, or the situation that it put, they said, yes, there will be, in principle, no a prohibition against the spouses leaving, which is an improvement over what they said before. However, they're still being checked. Security checks are still being made before they release the final list of those who will leave, which will include, of course, spouses. We cannot guarantee, we do not guarantee that all, every single spouse will be given the security check clearance, but at least they're open to it. So we'll see the final list.
How many more would want?
Anyway,
go ahead,
sir. Help us convince the remaining Filipinos to now go, because if it's a matter of your spouse, well, if they are given the clearance, then they can go.
Right, that's a very big factor. How many more have signified their intent of wanting to come back home, sir?
The numbers change. So let me check. At least 53 are at the border or are on their way to the border. So we're just waiting for the Israeli and Egyptian governments to release the list of those who will be approved, because it's a list that changes by day. Mm-hmm. There's no guarantee that when you're there, they'll allow you to cross, because they don't just let everybody cross, because they have to limit the numbers. And they limit it and provide a quota per nationality. Mm-hmm. But we have been guaranteed that we're ahead of the list in terms of quotas. So at least 53 are ready to go. So that could be, we hope it's more. We hope it's more, because there's still, let me see now, almost 90 left. Mm-hmm. 90 Filipinos left after the 40 who left. So, 53 is over half of them. So
that's
a positive step.
So hopefully there will be two more batches coming home, two or three more batches coming home.
Surely by this week as well. Mm-hmm. Certainly, yes.
Okay. Quickly switching to Lebanon, sir. A couple of days ago, around seven individuals were repatriated, and I believe there were more than 200 who would want to return in there. Most of them have their papers being processed right now. What's their situation, sir?
They're still being processed. And again, let me consult my notes, because they keep changing mm-hmm. by the minute, practically. There's another batch arriving tonight, actually. These are two Filipinos from the West Bank. The first two Filipinos arriving home from the West Bank between Israel and Jordan. For Beirut, there will be another batch arriving. They will be arriving 13 repatriates on Friday. So 13. They are going home little by little. What we're glad about, though, is that there's been no escalation.
Right.
There is still the problem in the south of Lebanon. But this is something which often happens when rockets are fired back. Beirut itself is calm. We still have encouraged the Filipinos to voluntarily repatriate. So we'll be working on the over 100 who still have to be repatriated. So they'll be coming in small batches because commercial flights are still available. In case it becomes worse, then we are ready to use a ship connection and use the port to bring them to safety. But the good news is that it's working. By the way, may I clarify for our viewers? DFA is in charge of the Filipinos in Gaza. Mm-hmm. EMW and OWA are in charge of repatriating Filipinos in Israel and Lebanon. And why is there a difference? Okay. Because the Filipinos in Israel and Lebanon are actually OFWs. They are contract workers, so that's under the EMW directive. And they have labor attachés, or migrant workers attachés, and welfare officers, both in Tel Aviv and Beirut. So that's the all-of-government approach that we're doing. We're cooperating with each other. And that way, I hope not to confuse people, because my title in the DFA is also Undersecretary for Migrant Workers Affairs. Eventually, mm-hmm. that will be revised or amended, because the Department of Migrant Workers now exists. We'll still be in charge of assisting Filipinos, but different. You know, we'll be having our own jurisdiction. So more exact information on this can be obtained from Mr. Katdak. But the good news is that, yes, patuloy-tuloy ang repatriation from Lebanon and even from Israel.
Yusek De Vega of the DFA, thank you very much, sir, again for your time.
Good afternoon. Assalamualaikum.
Good afternoon. That was Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega of the Department of Foreign Affairs giving us an update on the 40 Filipinos who have gone out of Gaza. Their trip has been delayed to Cairo by a couple of hours because of fog, but Yusek has assured us that they are in a very safe area. Yusek De Vega also reporting that two Filipinos from the West Bank are coming home tonight. And there are about 13 Filipinos coming from Beirut who may be home by Friday.